Oh my.
There are many cases all throughout human history where the legacy of an artist's creation goes on to overshadow him, and commonly goes on to outlive him. The artist is largely forgotten, and his work becomes a household image or name. He himself relegated within circles of the like-minded and those who share a deep interest in the same or similar field of work. The best examples I can think of in the modern internet age are that of Pepe the Frog and the online image board 4chan. Their legacies are tied tightly together. Although Pepe has gone on to become even bigger, many iterations of him cropping up all throughout the years. When you think of Pepe, what comes to your mind? I'll tell you what doesn't: his creator, nor the comic he came from. Without looking it up, there's a great chance you will not be able to think of his name. The same is the case of where Pepe was popularized, 4chan. Although he's a bit more known than Pepe's creator, it's not by a large margin. What they both have in common is a legacy that will far outlive them, and to a great extent, already has, for better and for worse. This is the story of a man whom, to many, betrayed anonymity and became lost in the shadow of his legacy. This is the story of Christopher Poole. Going in blind, what kind of temperament would you think the founder of such an infamous cultural setting phenomenon like 4chan would be? Maybe your first thought would be a grizzled, jaded, to the very bone webmaster, akin to the likes of Dread Pirate Roberts, the admin of one of the largest instances of the Silk Road, or maybe sharing the mentality of a shady gray hat or a full-on black hat hacker. Well, you'd be wrong. Poole is a very mild-mannered and considerate man. A great first impression, to those who have never heard of him, would be listening to his final Q&A, ironically.
Do you still hate Poole, number 567? No, I don't hate Poole. I don't hate anything on 4chan. I don't hate anybody. I find that it is a lot of work to hate strangers on the internet, and don't tend to spend my time doing that.
Poole founded 4chan in 2003 and captained its helm for nearly 12 years. He was the head admin and ran the site near entirely on his own, according to the aforementioned Q&A, posted on 4chan's official YouTube channel.
The prospect for the site was very grim. I mean, I am the, again, sole owner, sole manager, sole administrator. I own, the company. I own all of the hardware. I have every single password. I mean,
other than him at the top, it was a general manager below him, and below him were the volunteer mods and janitors.
You know, 4chan's hierarchy is essentially completely flat. I mean, it's volunteer moderators, or, janitors, I guess, the bottom, moderators, this kind of general manager type person, and then myself.
Poole made all the decisions and didn't consult anyone working under him. 4chan was a mutocracy, as he called it.
I don't consult moderators or janitors. I don't share my thinking. I don't. In that sense, I've been a pretty bad people manager. It's not a committee. It's not, consensus driven at all. It's really just I make decisions and sometimes communicate to them. A lot of time they're, pretty much completely in the dark.
If anything were to happen to him, be it life or, God forbid, death, 4chan would go with him.
What should happen to me if I were to become incapacitated, or, if I were to get hit by a bus and die, or again, like get a new job, get married, have kids, get burnt out, whatever. I mean, all of those things that would kind of take me away from the site, at a certain point in time, really probably would have ensured the site's death. It really didn't mean good things for the site. And so, it's like I've kind of joked in these interviews I've been that, it's like the opposite of, there's that saying, the captain goes down with the ship, but this was, the captain must go down with his ship, but this was like the ship goes down without the captain. This is like the second I take a step off the ship would like implode.
Toward the tail end of his administration, he worked to figure out a way to mitigate this, all while heavily contemplating his eventual resignation. During the majority of his time as head admin, Poole didn't stir much public controversies. Most of the notable events and happenings during his reign occurred completely independently of him. Although I'm sure he has dealt with the repercussions of tons of controversies 4chan had gotten itself into over the years. One of the biggest, and seemingly the straw that broke the camel's back, was the Fappening, where the site cleared nearly 1 billion page views because of the leaks. This overwhelmed him, not just because of the traffic, but because of the legal issues he had to deal with as a result. Even saying that if he hadn't had the foresight to save a solid amount of money, he along with the site would have gone bankrupt.
September was a really rough month. I mean, we started it with the Fappening, which you'd have to be under a rock to not know what that is. But, in that one day, so August, was it August 30th, 31st? I always forget how many days are in August, but, September 1st, the site was visited. I think we served about 93 million page views in one day. But anyway, you know, in that month, we served 45 million unique visitors and about 980 or so million page views. So the closest we've ever gotten to doing a billion page views. Actually, you know what? We probably did do a billion, just given that so many people, you know, all of our friends on GE block, you know, Google Analytics and whatnot, you know, the Google botnet. And so analytics is not always the best, you know, count. So I actually say, so that month we did break probably a billion page views. And, you know, I was just completely overwhelmed with, you know, we got many a legal nastygram from obviously all of the firms representing the, you know, the actresses, and you know, spent a shitload of time on the phone with lawyers, and spent a lot of money on lawyers. I mean, that I'm so glad that I've done such a good job at saving over the years, because that, you know, on a bad day could have easily bankrupted the site.
4chan was never a full-time job for Poole. He regarded managing it as a hobby. The site itself was never a profitable business model. Because of this, he founded and managed two other ventures while being its admin. Back in 2010, he launched the Canvas Network, and a couple years later in 2013, he launched DrawQuest, an app for iOS. Canvas was another image board service, but with a focus on the image aspect. It encouraged its users to remix images, regarded as a streamlined Photoshop, a way for artists and photo bashers to show their creative side and share it with others. DrawQuest was in a similar vein, primarily focusing on illustration challenges. Unfortunately, both companies proved unsustainable and unprofitable, and had to be shut down a couple of years later in January 2014. Just about a year after that, in 2015, he would announce his resignation as head admin of 4chan and post his final Q&A. He handed the reins of the site over to a few mods before finding the site's new owner later that same year. The man he sold it to was Hiroyuki Nishimura, the founder of 2channel. More on him a little later. After this, Poole would be hired at Google in 2016, this marking his slow descent into obscurity as his online presence gradually waned into non-existence. According to a few news articles like the CNBC and Business Insider, he would hold a few positions during his time there. First starting out as a project manager on the photo and streams team, later he would become a partner at Google's Area 20, a startup incubator within the company, and finally a project manager in the Google Maps division. During his time with Google, he was radio silent. His Twitter, his website, nothing. His online presence really only consisted of news articles writing about him. There were a total of 3 posts he directly made within the last 10 years. On Twitter, announcing his retirement as admin. On his now defunct website, Chris Hates Writing, announcing he had been hired at Google. And finally, again on his website, posting a simple goodbye emoji on April 25th of 2021. At least that's the earliest archive of this post. It's been 3 years since then, and nothing. Not even a news article. He's gone. Nowhere to be heard of and nowhere to be seen. He's blended back into the anonymous crowds of the internet.
I'm so tempted to say LMAO is my last words, but I'll just say see you later, Space Cowboy.
Poole is gone, but what about his legacy? Well, for the most part, it's still humming along. 8 new boards have been added since his departure, and of course it's under new management. Turn our focus to that for a bit. As mentioned previously, Hiroyuki Nishimura is now the owner and operator of 4chan, and has been since 2015. It's no secret that the business of 4chan isn't profitable, not directly, and hasn't been nearly for the entire time Poole ran it. It's simply within the site's nature and its user base. You'd be hard-pressed to find a line of people clamoring to spend $20 for a 4chan pass that only allows you to bypass the site's captcha systems and grants you access to posts on the VIP board. 4chan on its face is a passion project. Poole was always going to struggle to find a buyer. He even said in his final Q&A that there aren't many people that shared similar experiences out there, and even less whom would take it off his hands at a loss. A ship that would sink without its captain. It seemed like the only other options would be those whom could afford to eat the costs. However, I don't see big conglomerates like Meta taking the reins of something so volatile as 4chan. So why would Nishimura buy it? Well, there's a few reasons. Poole regarded him as 4chan's great-grandfather. He had created 2channel in 1999, which directly inspired the Futaba channel, 4chan's Japanese equivalent in 2001, then in turn inspiring 4chan itself in 2003. Who better than Nishimura? Someone with the experience of not only creating but also managing these sites and communities. Poole even stated on the news section of 4chan that they had bonded over their shared passion for the anonymous image board scene when they had first met. Would Nishimura really take it on to fulfill his own passion? The answer is unfortunately no. Remember when I said 4chan isn't profitable directly? Ads and the 4chan pass just aren't going to cut it. Nishimura knows this, so he decided to take a page out of the book of Zuck and make the users themselves the product. Nishimura has had a rather concerning history with data mining far before he acquired 4chan. In 2013, there was a large data breach of 2channel. The personal information of around 40,000 people were leaked. It included names, addresses, phone numbers, and all manner of sensitive data. Not only was the data leaked, the users had no idea the administration of 2channel was collecting it to begin with. It was all collected through HatuLink, a Japanese-based company specializing in data analytics. The president of HatuLink was, and still is, Koki Uchiyama, Nishimura's business partner. There were plenty of shady buyers as one would get through selling user data, but the most notable was Japan's still ruling political party, the LDP, or the Liberal Democrat Party. The LDP was, among many others, a customer of HatuLink. According to this article on anonymousjapan.org, the LDP would use HatuLink's services during the 2013 House of Counselors election, the House of Counselors being one of the two legislative bodies that are in charge of Japan's national legislature. HatuLink would then in turn be paid for their services, and subsequently the money would be funneled to the then Nishimura-controlled 2channel. To what end? Why was the LDP utilizing these services? I can tell you it wasn't for the sake of targeted ads. 2channel was Japan's most popular anonymous image board. What do you get with anonymous image boards? You get unfiltered opinions. Opinions that, in this case, the LDP didn't like very much. Through HatuLink, they could extinguish the fire of harsh criticism in internet communities. If the LDP didn't like it, you were gone. All the while, Nishimura was lining his pockets, selling user data to them. But Nishimura's shady behavior didn't end there. Fast forward to 2014, a big falling out happened between Nishimura and the other admin that ran 2channel with him, Jim Watkins, the owner of 8chan, and now 5channel, formerly 2channel. He seized pretty much everything from Nishimura and expelled him from the site. It's not hugely clear why he did this, but according to this article on the Japan Times, the post stated that the previous management had failed to earn sufficient money for running the servers, that his name had been slandered, and ended with the hope that proper management could make the site sustainable again. Through this seizure, other shady aspects of the site were uncovered, notably a paid service to delete posts. This was later confirmed by Uchiyama himself in a Facebook post. Not too long after, the aforementioned partnership between HatuLink and the LDP was also discovered. After 2channel was seized, Nishimura, as you'd expect, didn't take too kindly to this. According to this Reddit post made by a now-deleted user,
"I believe originally posted by Code Monkey Z or Ron Watkins, a site admin on 8chan.
After he was fired, he tried several tactics to gain control over 2chan, including abusing DNS, DDoS, and creating a fake version of 2chan that grabbed all the comments from the real 2chan automatically. His web crawlers continue to mirror 2chan posts to this day, causing great strain on the 2chan servers, at least at the time. It seems like he was and still is unsuccessful with gaining control back from Watkins, and he still holds total ownership of 2channel, now 5channel, to this day. Now onto his ownership of 4chan. Unfortunately, it's been more the same with Nishimura. 4chan is just his latest mining operation. He's even split the site in two. 4channel.org, reserved for a safe work and ad-friendly domain, and the original 4chan.org, the not safe for work domain. Here's how he's doing it. Nishimura is the director of a search engine company called Mirai Kensaku Brazil, or Future Search Brazil. He's using the engine to provide a real-time search for 4chan's text data. HatuLink acquired FS Inc. in 2015. It's a computer software systems analysis and design company located in Troy, Michigan.
There's another profile for FES that can be found on LinkedIn. It's located in Ypsilanti, Michigan. It also lists Koki Uchiyama as one of its employees.
It's the parent company of Sociologist, the, according to them, world's largest index of human-to-human conversational content, and BoardReader.com, the leading global social media content aggregation, provisioning, and search provider.
This is their homepage.
Brazil Future Search will funnel this data to EFIS and subsequently to Sociologist and BoardReader. They will provide whatever data collected back to EFIS and in turn back to HatuLink. HatuLink will then begin to sell whatever analytics data they have to whomever is willing to buy, thus lining Nishimura's pockets. If that wasn't bad enough, a few days before the sale took place, HatuLink, through EFIS, partnered with Foursquare, a company specializing in geolocation tagging. I don't think I need to explain much further than that. Well, that's it. That's how 4chan's been operating for the better part of a decade. The infamous anonymous image board has turned into a data mine for a Japanese tech mogul. I find it hard to believe Poole didn't know about any of Nishimura's activity prior to 4chan's acquisition. In fact, I'm almost certain he knew, but I don't think he really cared. Can't say I blame him too much. I can imagine having both your ventures fail and leaving you with a money pit of a site can be quite soul-crushing. Trying to break even would be the most logical course of action. For now, all we know is he's gone, and I don't think Nishimura is going to provide any insight on his whereabouts, if he even knows. Maybe he still works A, JP, or maybe even VT. It'd honestly be kind of funny if he'd gotten into VTubers. At the end of the day, Poole will always be known as the creator of 4chan, and 4chan will always precede him. I think that's a big reason why he's been near radio silent for almost a decade. Many have regarded it as a stigma. Even his former co-workers at Google saying his employment was tone-deaf. Barring a full return, explanation, and collaboration with fucking Pippa Pipkin,
I'm gonna fucking shoot up a Walmart!
There's probably some alphabet agency listening to this right now.
And Minecraft.
That reputation will likely never improve. To those on the outskirts of all this, he will remain in obscurity, behind the shadow of his legacy. And to those within, he will be regarded as one of the great pioneers of anonymous image boards, but also to many, as one of its great betrayers. My name is Chicken Broth, and until next time, get out.